Good morning, people. This is VJ Mowat for BBC Asia. The main story this morning is the death of the North Korean leader, Kim Jong-il. Kim Jong-il came to power in 1994, a great famine followed caused by bad economic decisions and poor harvest that left almost 2 million people dead. His rule has been criticized for human rights abuses and is internationally isolated because of his pursuit of nuclear weapons. Millions of North Koreans were engulfed in sadness, the state news agency said, as people wept openly in Pyongyang. It described one of his sons, Kim Jong-un, as a great successor whom North Koreans should unite behind. North Koreans' neighbors remain on alert amid fears of instability in the poor and isolated nuclear-armed nation. China, North Korea's closest ally and biggest trading partner, expressed shock at the news and promised to continue supporting North Korea. While other countries hoped this would be a turning point for North Korea to participate in the global community. Some facts about North Korea for our viewers this morning. Pyongyang is the capital city of North Korea. North Korea has a population of approximately 24 million. It has one of the largest militaries in the world. It's a communist dictatorship. In 2006, North Korea conducted its first nuclear test. The funeral of Kim Jong-il was held on 28 December, and Kim Jong-un succeeded his father. These were some photos taken on that day.
I believe in nothing, not the end and not the start. Believe in nothing, not the earth and not the stars. I believe in nothing, not the day and not the dark. I believe in nothing but the beating of our hearts.
Watches this secretive country cautiously, as when there is a domestic instability, North Korea likes to find an external situation to divert their attention away from that, including provocation. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That is all that we have for today. This is VJ Mowat for BBC Asia, signing off.